he was 16 years old and taken to Ireland as a slave. So he's actually enslaved by the Irish. And the Lord came to him in a dream, kind of giving him instructions on how to get onto a boat and get back to England. And he did. He escaped Ireland. He returned to England. But then shortly after he arrived back to England, he had another dream in which essentially he heard the Irish people crying out, you know, come back to us, share the gospel with us. And God just put such a heavy burden on Patrick's heart to go back to the land that had enslaved him and to share the gospel with them. And when he had this dream, he was scared and nervous, and at that time he was uneducated, and he thought, God, who am I, like, to go and teach these people about you? How am I going to communicate the gospel? And legend is that he shared what the Trinity was through the shamrock, through the three-leaf shamrock. That's how he explained the Trinity to folks who had never heard of the Trinity before. So long story short, he obeys God despite his fears. He goes to Ireland, and he shares the gospel across Ireland. And what was a pagan nation became a Christian nation because of this man's faith. So I just want to encourage you all today that God can use you just the same. He was an ordinary man being willing to be used by God. And so I just want to encourage you that no matter what your circumstances are, where you've come from, God wants to use you and wants to use you powerfully. So just be encouraged by that today. So, fun little tradition with St. Patrick's Day, the four-leaf clover. There actually is a four-leaf clover somewhere here in the auditorium under someone's chair. So you get to do a little hunt as we transition.